Hi, this is Anthony from MakeWeirdMusic.com. In this video, I want to talk about Frank Zappa and what he can offer you on your journey to make your own weird music. The first thing to know about Frank is he was a prolific genius. He was a self-taught composer. He wrote orchestral works on par with guys like Igor Stravinsky and John Cage. He played rock guitar like nobody else. He built and ran the Utility Muffin Research Kitchen. It's his home recording studio that's still in use today. He wrote and directed innovative and experimental feature-length films. He testified to Congress about the importance of free speech in music. He hired the best musicians in the industry, and he consistently filled concert venues around the world. He sold several gold albums. I could go on and on and on. The guy was incredible and a total workaholic. But let's talk about his music. His work spanned every genre in Western music, from disco.
Well, I go dancing every night, hoping one day I might get it right. I'm a dancing fool.
To jazz. To rock.
She lives in Mojave in a Winnebago. His name is Bobby. He looks like a potato.
To 1960s psychedelic.
Gotta go bye-bye, suddenly die-die. Cop, killer, creep, pow-pow-pow.
Tomorrow I get to do it. This is Frank Zappa.
It's a creation.
And the day after that, and the day after that.
Hi, boys and girls. I'm Jimmy Carl Black, and I'm the Indian of the group.
Concentrate.
To the blues. To atonal doo-wop a cappella.
Can't happen here. It can't happen here. I'm telling you, my dear, that it can't happen here. Because I've been checking it out, baby. I checked it out a couple of times.
To virtuosic stream of consciousness guitar solo instrumentals. Polyrhythmic progressive rock madness. To absolute nonsensical silliness.
Get on your feet and do the funky Alfonso.
The evil dope pusher is cutting up a white gym sock, formerly owned by Carl Zappa and still damp. The shredded sock will be placed inside of a high school diploma and ignited with a sulfur preparation.
Evelyn, a modified dog. View the quivering fringe of a special doily draped across the piano with some surprise.
His lyrics were ridiculous, offensive, funny, crude, satirical, lowbrow, and often meaningless, and I think he was proud of that. He didn't like to be confined to any boundaries, and he didn't like being labeled. So there's something for everyone to enjoy in his catalog, and there's also plenty to dislike and be offended by. He released 62 albums in his 27-year career, and after he died in 1993, another 37 albums were released by the Zappa Family Trust. His 100th and final album, called Dance Me This, is set to be released next month on Zappa.com. If the idea of finding something you like among his 100 albums sounds daunting, don't worry, we're going to be producing guides to his music categorized by genre. And if you can't wait until then, you should check out Weird Al Yankovic's incredible Frank Zappa tribute song called Genius in France. It's the closing track on his album Poodle Hat, and it features Dweezil Zappa, Frank's son, on electric guitar. The song's a great representation of Frank's humor, blending of genres, musical complexity in a straightforward rock song context, unpredictable instrumentation, plenty of weird sound effects. The song is really well done, and it provides a really great introduction to Frank and his style.
But nevertheless, and in spite of the evidence, I am so widely considered to be a genius in France, genius in France, genius in France.
Say I'm a geek, a moronic little freak, an annoying pipsqueak with an unfortunate physique. If I was any dumber, they'd have to water me twice a week.
So let me know what you think in the comments, and stay tuned for more content to inspire you in your weird music endeavors.